What's going on, guys? It's your boy Adoptionism here, bringing you guys video number 8. This is going to be on my second favorite class in the game, which is the Elementalist. The third one is the Reaver, if you guys didn't know. But first one, of course, is the Necromancer, because I just love mages in this game. They're just awesome. I love the versatility that they give. And yeah, Elementalist, this is going to be concentrating on the fire build. You can, I believe they do also have lightning. Yeah, they do have lightning, which is okay, but honestly, I really give two shits for it, because this one, if you get your rotation correctly and you pay attention to the, what I call the freebie cast, which is what this is, after you hit a critical hit, your next spell doesn't cost any cooldown. So that's really cool, and so yeah, if you time that correctly, you can actually end up double casting Firestorm, which is not the concentrate of the build, but it does massive damage. Technically, 12 hits, but they're in like in a scattered area, 1200% damage. Really cool. Oh, sorry, that's my phone going off. My bad, guys. But yeah, so to get this started, because obviously higher difficulties, you're going to want to concentrate on doing door traps. So the fire mine is like the main build or the main spec of what you do in this class. And I'll show you why here in a sec. So just to start off in the destruction tree, obviously you start off with immolate. I mean, you can end up upgrading if you want, but I think that throws it off. You want to get conductive current, so damage bonus, you get 5% for every 10% missing mana, so that's really great. Really, really, really good boost. Flashpoint, of course, wanting to get that cooldown stuff going. Now, some people are saying that the duration bonus drags out the damage over time that you do. So instead of, say, doing 100 damage per second, say if you did 100 damage per second for 10 seconds or whatever, and you use this, and then it drags out to, say, 12 seconds, and that means that you'd only be doing, like 85 damage per second. So that's some speculation. I don't think so. I'm pretty sure it still continues doing your 100% or your 100 damage over each second, whatever, but just adds on a couple more seconds. But hopefully by this build, you can usually kill shit before you actually before your dot actually kills it. So yeah, after Flashpoint, you want to get Clean Burn, which is after every spell you cast, which is whatever's in your rotation. It takes down your cooldowns by 1 second, so that's always helpful. And then, of course, we want to get the Fire Mine. That's already 1600% weapon damage. Now you gotta always keep in mind that there is that 3 second activation delay, so if there's like a big guy or a crowd of people running in front of you, just make sure you plant that in time, so that way by the time they walk over, boom, it hits them. And the burning damage is okay. I mean, it doesn't hurt. I mean, 200% weapon damage per second for 8 seconds, so that's pretty much an equivalent to 1600% damage. So that plus that, that's 3200% damage within that 8 second time period. So that's actually a shit ton of damage, and you also see why it'll even be more on the other tree. And then yeah, of course we go down, we get Pyromancer just to get a burning duration bonus, 25%, and you have to get Death Siphon. Death Siphon is what keeps you alive as a mage. And then of course we get Firestorm. So yeah, let's go on to the next tree, and then we'll count everything else out. And of course you have Winter's Grasp at the start, then you got to get Peaceful Aura, Winter Stillness to get that mana regen. Gathering Storm is really great because you get that cooldown for basic attacks, which is really, really good, especially after you put down all your stuff and you're waiting for the cooldowns. You sit in the back and you just keep popping at them while they're getting hit with Meteor Storm and shit like that. So that's really great. And then you get Guardian Spirit because that's what you got to get. And then you get Barrier. Your Barrier already starts at 3,156, so that's retarded. And then you get Strength of the Spirits, which increases that by 50%. 50% of 3156 is about, I want to say like 15, yeah, it's around 1500. So that means that's going to bump it up to a little over 4600. Then you get Chaotic Focus, which actually gives you another 50% barrier bonus. So technically, you get 100% barrier increase, so that's actually going to be over 6300. Yeah, that's over 6,300 is what your barrier is going to be at to absorb damage. That's crazy. But you don't have anything to slow down the decay, so that's the downside. But at the same time, of course, and I mean, it's still pretty good. But yeah, chaotic focus makes it to where it consumes half of your current barrier to empower it. Pretty much meaning, say, if we cast barrier, and then as soon as we cast barrier, like, so pretty much we're going to end up casting barrier, and then we do, let's say, the fire mine, okay? That fire mine is going to not only have that 3,200% weapon damage, but on top of all that, it's going to do 50%, which is obviously if we have 100% plus that, it's going to be 3,156 damage to it. So that's a lot of fucking damage. And yeah, I mean, you just do that, plant that down, you get that as your rotation. And at the same time, another good thing is for people who didn't know is that for the demons, when they rip the rift in the ground or whatever, and they teleport down, as soon as you see one of them do that, plant a fire mine just right where you're standing. Because granted, you'll get knocked down, but it fucks them up. Like, they won't do their little like shrieking thing like off the bat like they normally do. They'll actually get knocked down from it. And at the same time, get a shit ton of damage dealt to them. So yeah, let's go ahead and let's count down and see what we have right now. We got level 2, 3, level 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17. So yeah, we do 17, so then that means that we have 18, 19, 20, so we have 3 levels left. I guess you could go ahead and do Veiled Riposte or whatever, or Riposte, I don't fucking know what that word is, whatever, Riposte, fuck. So that'll be 18, level 18. Alright, and then after that, let's see, I guess we can go ahead and do level 19 and level 20, so that way... Well, actually, just level 19, because you do that and you fear like anything that touches it. If you're doing door traps, that's really good. If you put it a little bit behind the door so they walk into your mine, and then when they hit your wall of fire, they end up actually getting feared, so they won't actually attack you, so that's really good. And I don't know, I guess, yeah. So that has to be your rotation right there, is firewall, fire mine, firestorm, and... guess emulate, maybe. Actually, I don't know. We might not actually need emulate. I might actually would do... yeah, I think I would probably actually do energy barrage, because the cooldown is only 16 seconds, and we have so much mana regen between the passives and the death siphon that we could actually probably end up spamming spirit barrage. So I'm going to say spirit barrage, fully upgraded, take out their damage resistance. Actually, no, fuck that. Just do spirit barrage or energy barrage once, and you got firestorm, fire mine, and firewall. So those four right here in this little area, these are what you want. So yeah, again, we got level 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15. 16, 17, 18, 19, and 20. Why not? Yeah, I guess that would work. 20. What was the other passive for this one? Oh, no. Actually, make that 20. Yeah, make that, because the more damage that you have, the better. So, pretty much this whole bottom part you want. Only need the first part of firewall. You don't need the second. Only need the first part of energy barrage. But for fire mine, you want both. So yeah, that's my build for the Elementalist. Definitely can't wait to get this chick leveled up more. Or dude, I don't fucking... yeah, it's a dude. But yeah, guys, until next time, this has been your boy Adopt. I hope this helps you guys out. Please don't forget to leave a like, comment, subscribe. Don't forget to follow me on Twitter at Adoptionism. Link is down in the description below. And as always, don't forget to check out my buddy Jay's stream. All of his links are down in the description as well. And also, don't forget to stop by 7controllers.com to get any paddled competitive controllers. I believe... next month, right now we're in December, I think next month they're going to be releasing accessories, so that'll be really cool. And don't forget to use discount code ADOPT, A-D-O-P-T, upon your checkout to get 5% off, so that way it'll show your support for me, and at the same time, I'll be able to show my gratitude towards you guys in a way of getting stuff cheaper for you. So yeah, I really appreciate this, and thank you for your time and watching my video. Until next time, guys, this has been ADOPT. Peace out.